you. An upstate school district is waiting for all this rain to see if a leaking problem in three of their brand new schools has been fixed. News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local in Anderson tonight. Mandy, the district says there's no health hazard to students, though, right?
Right. The assistant superintendent says the leaks at schools like Glenview Middle aren't causing mold issues, but the problem is with the HVAC units that you can kind of see behind me on the roof. And another problem at this particular school has been with the flashing.
At a brand new school like Glenview Middle, the last thing you might expect is a problem with the roof.
Anything new, we expect it to be perfect, but it's just not perfect. It'll never will be.
But since the school opened its doors last school year, that's exactly what they faced. Roof leaks that have seeped into the ceiling and at its worst even came down the walls near computers. We're told those severe leaks have been fixed, but when there's a heavy rain, little ones still pop up.
We have new schools with roof leaks, and it's not something that we're proud of. We love our new schools, and we're going to get those fixed just as quickly as possible.
Glenview isn't alone. Robert Anderson Middle and North Point Elementary, both new as well, are also having leaky roofs. But Anderson District 5 Assistant Superintendent Tripp Dukes says the contractors have been responsive in getting each one fixed.
Generally speaking, the HVAC units that go on top of the building has had leaks. Some of it is from the factory in terms of the equipment that's up there. Others are from conduit that has to go into the school.
Until the leaky problem is dried up, the district is withholding payment.
So they have incentive to get them fixed, and we have incentive to get them fixed.
So that they can have the kind of schools taxpayers are paying for.
Now, I did try to get in touch with both construction companies that built these three schools, Matrix here in Anderson and Shellco based out of Charlotte. As of yet, I have not heard back yet from either. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in Anderson County.
All right, Mandy, thank you.